Good morning, children. Welcome to the online classes for the 10th standard of 11th period. So, in this 11th period, we are going to discuss the topic related to the political science. So, in the last class, we have discussed the point related to the political science, that is the first unit. But in this class, we are going to discuss the second unit. The name of the unit is Indian Foreign Policy. Indian Foreign Policy. So that is the second unit we are going to get in this class. So first we have to get what is the idea or what is the meaning of Indian Foreign Policy. So we know that the foreign means automatically we know that the meaning of foreign. Foreign it means it is the point related to the other country. So here what we are going to discuss in this chapter, the Indian foreign policy, the Indian policy which is related to the foreign countries, which is made for the foreign countries. In this chapter, we are going to discuss the points related to the foreign policy. Foreign policy means, we can take the example that when we need the help, in a family, we are having many families in the societies, but there is a compulsory relation we have to be get with the other families. So one single family cannot be solve the problems related to the society. So it needed the help of other families. Like that way, here the foreign policy also become a very important part for the any country to solve it. Problem. So that's why the many countries they are going to make the different foreign policies to get the connected with the other countries or to develop the relations with the other countries. That is called as the foreign policy. We can say in the short interaction between the two countries. Interaction between the two countries itself is going to called as the foreign policy. So come to the point related to the textbook. According to our textbook, we are going to get the knowledge related to the foreign policy is a study of how different countries interact with each other and the type of relations they have strive to maintain is needed. So what this sentence telling us, how type of different countries interact with the each other. They are going to make the interaction between the two countries or many countries, but it is depend upon their problem or their need. So here the type of relation they are strive to maintain is needed, because without any point, they are not going to discuss any kind of points related to the other countries or the our countries. We must have some policy and it should be needed for the country. You can take the present example itself only. Now, the world is getting problem due to the COVID-19. So, only India cannot be fight for the one country without the interaction with the other countries. So this time is too needed to get the help of other countries. That time we must have the what point? Foreign policy. You can take the example of present. We are finding the discussion of the Third World War due to the China made problem for the many countries or the world. So this rise of Third World War also comes with the some conditions made by the foreign policies by the different countries. If you want to develop their relation with the USA, we must have the foreign policy. We must have the policy to get relations with the China, Pakistan or any country which is needed to us. According to that only, we are going to discuss the foreign points or foreign policy. But in the other way, we are finding just like an individual who cannot live alone, countries also cannot live alone. You know that group of children we are finding in the class. If you are coming to the school, you are not going alone to do any work. We are doing the work with the group. So in the same way, if the country wants to solve the problem, we must have the relations with the other countries. If only single country cannot be solved, the problem related to the country. So that is the main point we are going to see regarding the foreign policy. Now, third point is, hence, every country needs to have foreign policy to regulate its interaction with the other countries. We want to interact with the other countries. We want to discuss with the points related to the other countries. We must have the foreign policy. We must have the relations with the other countries. That is called as the foreign policy. Third point, out of more than 200 countries we are going to see in the world, or more than 200 countries are there in the world. Out of 200 countries in the world, very few countries are strong and most of them are very weak. So you know the point related to the UNO, United Nations of Organization. So why this United Nations of Organization was developed after the first time the Second World War? Because to maintain the peace in the world, to make develop the peace in the world, by making the development of UNO, we are finding there was the development started to get the connectivity of different countries. Now, hence, these 200 countries must have the relations with each other to solve the problem. Otherwise, there may be the problem from the weaker, the strong countries toward the weak country. Suppose you can take the example of America and India. America is a strong country and India was very weak at the time of 1947. So present day, we are able to fight against any countries, but then also we must have the good relations with the other countries. That is, a strong country may be going to make problems toward the weak country. For that, even now maintaining the peace with the weak and the strong countries. Okay, so that is called as a foreign policy. Come to the other point related to the this foreign policy. According to the experts, every sovereign country has its own foreign. Now, UN is going to make the one policy related to the all 200 countries. That is different. But each sovereign country, you know the meaning of sovereign. Sovereign means the independent country who is having the their own power. That type of independent country or the sovereign country having its own rights to develop its own policies, and they can make any kind of policies and any kind of principles they can follow with the any countries according to their choice due to the sovereign countries. Now, a sovereign country is that country which is not under any other country's control, either in internal or the external affairs. You can take the example, if you are, I am an independent person, I may not be going to get the help of to maintain the policies to get the development of friendship. So here the countries also, the sovereign countries, they are having the their own power. They can maintain the good relations with the other countries. They may not be going to maintain the good relations with the other countries. That is dependent upon their own choice, and there is no any restrictions to the these sovereign country to make compulsory relations with the other countries in the regarding this point. So the points can be choice by the their own countries, and they can make their own foreign policy in their sovereign country. So these type of things, there is no any external and the internal issues are coming from the other countries. And it's an important point to note that the India has its own foreign policy before independence and also the after independence. So we know that before independence also India was one of the country who was maintained its own foreign policy. It means at the time of when we are getting the independence, the Jawaharlal Nehru, Motilal Nehru, these people have developed the Indian foreign policy before the independence also. Then after independence also, we are finding India is having its own foreign policy. Then it is also following the international policy with the United Nations of Organization. So it is totally different from the other countries. And it is considered that India is totally different because you know that India is having a more population or huge population we are finding in the country, and due to huge population and the variety of natural resources and variety of military sections and other intellectual facts things we are going to see in our country. So totally our policy is totally different from the other countries. So it may be the different country we can say from the other countries of the world. And there is the new development we are going to see in our countries, that is industrialization development also started in India, and this industrialized development is the different from other countries. So another point we can see, India is going to be called one of the few countries in the world who pursue their own foreign policy as like India. So India always following the different way from the other countries. Like that way, some other few countries also there in the world who are following their its own foreign policies. So how they are following its own foreign policy means, we know that India is always going to be called as a peace country. Why it is going to call peace country? Because India always wants to follow the non-violence in the world, not the violence in the world. That's why Indian foreign policy is always called as the different one from the world. Because India not only want to develop the peace in the country, but it wants to develop the peace in the total world. It don't want to make non-violence in the world. It wants to develop the non-violence since from the before independence and the after independence also. So the next point we are going to see is India become a republic in 1947. That we know. India got independent in 1947. That we know very well every year. Now, as an independent country, as it become an independent country, now India want to develop the peaceful. It want to develop the peaceful, or it want to get the coexistence with the other countries. That's why the countries of the world, that's why it has started to make the plan for the preparation of the Indian foreign policy. It started after independence to make the Indian foreign policy with the some important aims. Because if we are going to do the work, before going to do the work, we are going to make the preparation for the aims of that work. You can take the example of you are starting one of the business. At that time, you are going to make some plan. In future, I want to reach this stage. So that kind of aims also going to put by the government for making the relations with the other countries. In the same way, after 1947, Indian government has started to develop the major aims for development of the Indian foreign policy. The main five aims are given in your book. You can see in your textbook. So there are important 5 M's we are going to see. First one is the national security. Why we needed the interaction with the other countries? Because we want the support of the security for our country. That was the first aim of the Indian foreign policy. Now today, the China is going to make problem to us. But now in this period, we needed what? The security from the other countries. So we are finding the security from the Israel. We are finding the security from the Russia. We are finding the security from the America. How it comes? After the development of foreign relations with the other countries. So that's why their choice, the first point is national security is a very important aim. And second point is enriching the national economy. Because at the time of 1947, India was in a very weak position with the wealth. Because this time, you know that British and the many Islam kings have looted to the country, and at the time of 1947, the state of the country was very weak. So to get the economic development or the national economy, we must have the good relations with the other countries. So after that only we are finding the development of industries in the country. Next, third point is spreading the cultural richness of our country in the other countries. You know that traditional culture of India was different, but what was the present culture of India? 50%, or you can say 60% culture we are finding, it is related to the Western countries today in India. Why? Because 60% of the people are living in the different parts of the world in the present day. So they are following this culture. Why Indians got to go toward the other countries? Because to spread the culture. So we are spreading the culture in their countries, and we are getting the culture of other countries towards us. So today our 60% people are related to the Western culture, and many other people belong to the Malaysia, the people belong to the USA, the people belong to the Switzerland, they are also following the culture of India. So to make the change in the culture, they have kept the point in the Indian foreign policy that the cultural richness of our country should be reached to the other countries as a mutual changes. Last fourth point is increasing the number of friendly countries and check the power of enemy countries. The other aim of Indian foreign policy was to get more relations with the among these 200 countries, and we want to check the what was the power of different countries. We want to see the power of USA. We want to see the power of North Korea. We want to see the power of South Korea. We want to see the power of China, Bangla, Afghanistan, Pakistan. And we want to develop the good relations with these countries also, because we want to maintain the peace in the world. That's why they have kept the fourth point is, it is compulsory to get the number of friendly countries and check the power of enemies, because in future it may be the problem getting created toward the India. The last point is achieving world peace and coexistence. The last point is India want to achieve not the peace not only in the country, but it want to achieve the peace in the foreign countries also. It fights many times to maintain the peace, and we would want to get the coexistence with the other countries. It want to get the correlations with the other countries. So that type of Indian foreign policy was developed first time in India after the becoming the republic country in 1947. Then after the development of the Indian foreign policy, we are going to see one of the speech was given by the Jawaharlal Nehru, who is going to be called as the first Prime Minister of India before the independence. So once in the 1946, on September 7, Jawaharlal Nehru outlined that the point related to the foreign policy. He was declared in front of the common people belongs to the India, because that time, that's why it is going to be called as India has developed the foreign policy before the independence also, because it was a pre-planned made by the Jawaharlal Nehru with his friends in the 1946 itself. So first time to the general public, the declaration was made on the radio. So that time the speech gave an idealization of the foreign relations in India is going to be fostered with the countries like America, Russia and the China. So that time the declaration was made by the Jawaharlal Nehru that we are developing the relations with the USA, we are developing the relations with the Russia, we are developing the relations with the China, because the common people of the country can know the point what the Prime Minister is doing for the country by maintaining the foreign policy. So that time again the Jawaharlal Nehru managed the foreign policies of the India as a external affairs, and the minister apart from being the Prime Minister as the as well. So when after 1947 when become the Prime Minister for India, he was not working only as a Prime Minister, who Jawaharlal Nehru, but he was maintaining the foreign relations. He was become the one of the foreign minister to develop the relations with the other countries. So he was doing the internal work and also with the external work to follow the good relations. That job was completed by the Jawaharlal Nehru. That also declared in the radio program. Hence, many of times the foreign policies of the India is also called as the foreign policies of Nehru. So due to the hard work made by the Nehru, it is going to called as the, what was the Indian foreign policy was developed by Indian government, that foreign policy is going to be called as the Indian Nehru policy developed with the foreign countries. Then the various international and the national issues have influenced the foreign policy of India. Due to the development of this Indian foreign policy, many of the few other countries also motivated toward the Indian foreign policy. They have started to use the Indian foreign policy because they are finding this policy is very good for their countries also, and it was benefited to them. So they have started to utilize the Indian foreign policy which was developed by Indian government. So the point related to the this interest was, it is like national interest, geographical interest, political situations, economic interest, military issues, public opinions, international situations and many other issues have influenced the shape of Indian foreign policy. Why the other countries have started to motivate toward the Indian foreign policy? Because this foreign policy connected with the many points, many activities. The activities like economic development, political development, military development, natural development, national development, and also international good relations development. And there was also a point we are finding they want to develop the peace in the world. So that's why it became a very important part for the foreign policy related to the India, which developed in the period of before independence and the after independence by our national leaders. So the next point is, we are going to see after this we are finding India also developed some new points. So these are the last few points, just related to the only what purpose, only the purpose of, that is the point related to the India itself. It is going to be called as the Indian foreign policy. It was not with the other countries. And the next policy was developed by the Indian government after independence, that at the time of need, that in the 1954 with the China, that is called as the foreign policy started by the Indian government. So the next point, India has started the development of foreign policy because it was thought that it was a need for the India. So the first Indian foreign policy was started in the 1954, because always India want to develop the foreign policy according to the needs and for the development of few activities in the country, because at the time of when reached to the independence, the India was totally a poor country in the world. It was going to be called as a poor country. So that time, one of the principle followed, that is going to be called as the basic aspects of the Indian foreign policy, it was started in the 1947 with the some different principles. So India started the first principles, and the first foreign policy was developed in 1954 with China. So that policy itself is going to be called as the Panchsheela foreign policy. It means the policy started with the name of Panchsheela principles. Panchsheela principles means there are five principles followed by the two countries to maintain the relation. So why these two countries needed the development or the needed the maintenance of the foreign policy with each other? Because the aim of these Panchsheela principles was, though the countries are having their own all development, again they needed the development of their social development, economical development, political development, cultural development, and they want to develop the relations, good relations with the other countries, even though already they are having all these points with their countries. They are having the cultural system, they are having the economic system, they are having the political system, they are having their own social system, but still again these countries want to share their these all activities to each other to maintain the peace among the two countries. So first time the India was developed the foreign policy based on the similar lines in 1954. So both the India and China has accepted the Panchsheela principles. They have agreed to sign the which principles? Panchsheela principles. There are the five principles were written in the document. According to this document, both the countries' prime ministers have signed to this agreement. So what were the points related to this agreement made between the China and India in 1954? So according to this Panchsheela principles, they want to foster the international relations. They want to develop the international relationship. So that time Jawaharlal Nehru, the Prime Minister of India, and the Enlai was the Prime Minister for China, both have agreed to sign the Panchashila principles and they are ready to agree the following points. So what are the following points related to this agreement made by the both countries? So there are the few points we are going to see related to the Panchashila agreement or the Panchashila principles followed by the government of India and the government of China. So the first point is respecting the each other sovereignty and the regional interest. So India is also going to be called as a sovereign country. China is also going to be called as a sovereign country, but there is no any inter-state or the inter-country relations or internal issues should not be disturbed by the any country. So they can make their own choice. They can follow their own steps to develop their countries. But regarding the discussion with the two countries, they can discuss any point. Here means we must respect to the each sovereignty. For their independence, we have to be give respect and we have to be maintain the regional interest. We have to follow our own country development, not to the other country's point. It should might not discuss with the each other. So they have to be show interest their regional power. Next point is non-invention of each other. So why they have agreed to sign this agreement? There is no invention on each other countries. India should not make attack toward the China and China should not make attack toward the India at any condition. That was the second point written in this document. And third one, that is non-interference in each other international issues. If they are following any relations with the other countries, China may be going to get the relations with the Russia, India may be going to get the relations with the America, that time China should not make any issues toward the international or the internal issues related to the India, or the India should not make any issue toward the China at the time of internal issue related to that country. That was the third agreement made by these two countries. And fourth one is the mutual cooperation and the respect. So each country has to respect each other and they have to be given the respect for the both countries. So India has to give the respect to the China, China has to give the respect to the India. That fourth point added to get the mutual understanding at the time of any emergencies. Last one, peaceful coexistence. So both countries have to go with the peaceful. There is no violence. There is no any war with these countries. They have to be helpful each other to develop the peace in the country or to maintain the peace in the country. That type of systems or the five conditions are made by the India and China with the two Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru and the Enlai. So these are the important points we are going to see related to the Panchashila principles. So Panchashila principles are different from the Indian foreign policy because India made some, earlier we have studied some 5 points that are related to only India, and this only related to the agreement made between the India and China. Don't get any confusion. So this is the only point related to the India-China. But earlier 5 points that are related to the only India. India can maintain those 5 points with any countries on its choice. But these 5 points only maintained with the China at the time of Enlai, the Prime Minister of China. So these are the points have followed by these two countries By this way, these are the basic fine building blocks of India in the foreign policy was started first time in the 1954. By this way, today I want to stop this topic here only. So once children, you get the read of, you know this point given in your page number 70 related to the Jawaharlal Nehru. Once read it, get the idea and continue to be know the points related to the Indian foreign policy. So once you read in the house, that is your homework. Thank you. Good morning, children. Welcome to the online classes for the 10th standard of 11th period. So in this 11th period, we are going to discuss the topic related to the political science. So in the last class, we have discussed the point related to the political science, that is the first unit. But in this class, we are going to discuss the second unit. The name of the unit is Indian Foreign Policy. Indian Foreign Policy. So that is the second unit we are going to get in this class. So first we have to get what is the idea or what is the meaning of Indian foreign policy. So we know that the foreign means, automatically we know that the meaning of foreign. Foreign it means it is the point related to the other country. So here what we are going to discuss in this chapter, the Indian foreign policy. The Indian policy which is related to the foreign countries, which is made for the foreign countries. In this chapter, we are going to discuss the points related to the foreign policy. Foreign policy means, you can take the example that when we need the help in a family, we are having many families in the societies, but there is a compulsory relation we have to be get with the other families. So one single family cannot be solve the problems related to the society. So it needed the help of other families. Like that way, here the foreign policy also become a very important part for the any country to solve its problems. So that's why the many countries, they are going to make the different foreign policies to get the connected with the other countries or to develop the relations with the other countries. That is called as the foreign policy. We can say in the short, interaction between the two countries. Interaction between the two countries itself is going to called as the foreign policy. So come to the point related to the textbook. According to our textbook, we are going to get the knowledge related to the foreign policy is a study of how different countries interact with each other and the type of relations they have strive to maintain is needed. So what this sentence telling us, how type of different countries interact with the each other. They are going to make the interaction between the two countries or many countries, but it is dependent upon their problem or their need. So here the type of relation they are strive to maintain is needed, because without any point they are not going to discuss any kind of points related to the other countries or the our countries. We must have some policy and it should be needed for the country. You can take the present example itself only. Now the world is getting problem due to the COVID-19. So only India cannot be fight for the one country without the interaction with the other countries. So this time is too needed to get the help of other countries. That time we must have the what point? Foreign policy. You can take the example of present we are finding the discussion of the Third World War due to the China made problem for the many countries of the world. So this rise of Third World War also comes with the some conditions made by the foreign policies by the different countries. If you want to develop their relation with the USA, we must have the foreign policy. We must have the policy to get relations with the China, Pakistan or any country which is needed to us. According to that only, we are going to discuss the foreign points or the foreign policy. But in the other way, we are finding just like an individual who cannot live alone, countries also cannot live alone. You know that group of children we are finding in the class. If you are coming to the school, you are not going alone to do any work. We are doing the work with the group. So in the same way, if the country wants to solve the problem, we must have the relations with the other countries. If only single country cannot be solved, the problem related to the country. So that is the main point we are going to see regarding the foreign policy. Now, third point is, hence, every country needs to have foreign policy to regulate its interaction with the other countries. We want to interact with the other countries. We want to discuss with the points related to the other countries. We must have the foreign policy. We must have the relations with the other countries. That is called as the foreign policy. Third point, out of more than 200 countries we are going to see in the world, or more than 200 countries are there in the world. Out of 200 countries in the world, very few countries are strong and most of them are very weak. So you know the point related to the UNO, United Nations of Organization. So why this United Nations of Organization was developed after the first time the Second World War? Because to maintain the peace in the world, to make develop the peace in the world, by making the development of UNO, we are finding there was the development started to get the connectivity of different countries. Now, hence, these 200 countries must have the relations with each other to solve the problem. Otherwise, there may be the problem from the which the strong countries toward the weak country. Suppose you can take the example of America and India. America is a strong country and India was very weak at the time of 1947. So present day we are able to fight against any countries, but then also we must have the good relations with the other countries. That is, a strong country may be going to make problems toward the weak country. For that, even now maintaining the peace with the weak and the strong countries. Okay, so that is called as a foreign policy. Come to the other point related to the this foreign policy. According to the experts, every sovereign country has its own foreign policy. Now, even is going to make the one policy related to the all 200 countries, that is different. But each sovereign country, you know the meaning of sovereign. Sovereign means the independent country who having the their own power. That type of independent country or the sovereign country having its own rights to develop its own policies, and they can make any kind of policies or any kind of principles they can follow with the any countries according to their choice due to the sovereign countries. Now, a sovereign country is that country which is not under any other country's control, either in internal or the external affairs. You can take the example, if you are, I am an independent person, I may not be going to get the help of to maintain the policies to get the development of clientship. So here the countries also, the sovereign countries, they are having the their own power. They can maintain the good relations with the other countries. They may not be going to maintain the good relations with the other countries. That is dependent upon their own choice, and there is no any restrictions to the these sovereign countries to make compulsory relations with the other countries in the regarding this point. So the points can be choice by the their own countries, and they can make their own foreign policy in their sovereign country. So these type of things, there is no any external and the internal issues are coming from the other countries. And it's an important point to note that the India has its own foreign policy before independence and also the after independence. So we know that before independence also India was one of the country who was maintain its own foreign policy. It means at the time of when we are getting the independence, the Jawaharlal Nehru, Motilal Nehru, these people have developed the Indian foreign policy before the independence also. Then after independence also, we are finding India is having its own foreign policy. Then it is also following the international policy with the United Nations of organization. So it is totally different from the other countries. And it is considered that India is totally different because you know that India is having a more population or huge population we are finding in the country, and due to huge population and the variety of natural resources and variety of military sections and other intellectual facts things we are going to see in our country. So totally our policy is totally different from the other countries. So it may be the different country we can say from the other countries of the world. And there is the new development we are going to see in our countries, that is industrialization development also started in India, and this industrialized development is the different from other countries. So another point we can see, India is going to be called one of the few countries in the world who pursue their own foreign policy as like India. So India always following the different way from the other countries. Like that way, some other few countries also there in the world who are following their its own foreign policy. So how they are following its own foreign policy means, we know that India is always going to be called as a peace country. Why it is going to call peace country? Because India always wants to follow the non-violence in the world, not the violence in the world. That's why Indian foreign policy is always called as the different one from the world. Because India not only want to develop the peace in the country, but it want to develop the peace in the total world. It don't want to make non-violence in the world. It want to develop the non-violence since from the before independence and the after independence also. So the next point we are going to see is India become a republic in 1947. That we know. India got independent in the 1947. That we know very well every year. Now, as an independent country, as it become an independent country, now India want to develop the peaceful. It want to develop the peaceful, or it want to get the coexistence with the other countries. That's why the countries of the world, that's why it has started to make the plan for the preparation of the Indian foreign policy. It started after independence to make the Indian foreign policy with the some important aims. because if we are going to do the work, before going to do the work, we are going to make the preparation for the aims of that work. You can take the example of you are starting one of the business. At that time, you are going to make some plan. In future, I want to reach this stage. So that kind of aims also going to put by the government for making the relations with the other countries. In the same way, after 1947, Indian government has started to develop the major aims for development of the Indian foreign policy. The main 5 aims are given in your book, you can see in your textbook. So there are important 5 aims we are going to see. First one is the national security. Why we needed the interaction with the other countries? Because we want the support of the security for our country. That was the first aim of the Indian foreign policy. Now today, the China is going to make problem to us, but now in this period, we needed what? The security from the other countries. So we are finding the security from the Israel, we are finding the security from the Russia, we are finding the security from the America. How it comes? After the development of foreign relations with the other countries. So that's why their choice, the first point is national security is a very important aim. And second point is enriching the national economy. Because at the time of 1947, India was in a very weak position with the wealth. Because this time, you know that British and the many Islam kings have looted to the country, and at the time of 1947, the state of the country was very weak. So to get the economic development or the national economy, we must have the good relations with the other countries. So after that only we are finding the development of industries in the country. Next, third point is spreading the cultural richness of our country in the other countries. You know that traditional culture of India was different, but what was the present culture of India? 50%, or you can say 60% culture we are finding, it is related to the Western countries today in India. Why? Because 60% of the people are living in the different parts of the world in the present day. So they are following this culture. Why Indians got to go toward the other countries? Because to spread the culture. So we are spreading the culture in their countries, and we are getting the culture of other countries towards us. So today our 60% people are related to the Western culture, and many other people belong to the Malaysia, the people belong to the USA, the people belong to the Switzerland. They are also following the culture of India. So to make the change in the culture, they have kept the point in the Indian foreign policy that the cultural richness of our country should be reached to the other countries as a mutual changes. Last fourth point is increasing the number of friendly countries and check the power of enemy countries. The other aim of Indian foreign policy was to get more relations with the among these 200 countries, and we want to check the what was the power of different countries. We want to see the power of USA, we want to see the power of North Korea, we want to see the power of South Korea, we want to see the power of China, Bangla, Afghanistan, Pakistan, and we want to develop the good relations with these countries also, because we want to maintain the peace in the world. That's why they have kept the fourth point is it is compulsory to get the number of friendly countries and check the power of enemies, because in future it may be the problem getting created toward the India. The last point is achieving world peace. Achieving world peace and coexistence. The last point is India want to achieve not the peace not only in the country, but it want to achieve the peace in the foreign countries also. It fights many times to maintain the peace, and it would want to get the coexistence with the other countries. It want to get the correlations with the other countries. So that type of Indian foreign policy was developed first time in India after the becoming the republic country in 1947. Then after the development of the Indian foreign policy, we are going to see one of the speech was given by the Jawaharlal Nehru, who is going to be called as the first Prime Minister of India before the independence. So once in the 1946, on September 7, Jawaharlal Nehru outlined that the point related to the foreign policy. He was declared in front of the common people belongs to the India, because that time, that's why it is going to be called as India has developed the foreign policy before the independence also, because it was a pre-plan made by the Jawaharlal Nehru with his friends in the 1946 itself. So first time to the general public, the declaration was made on the radio. So that time the speech gave an idealization of the foreign relations in India is going to be fostered with the countries like America, Russia and the China. So that time the declaration was made by the Jawaharlal Nehru that we are developing the relations with the USA, we are developing the relations with the Russia, we are developing the relations with the China, because the common people of the country can know the point what the Prime Minister is doing for the country by maintaining the foreign policy. So that time again the Jawaharlal Nehru managed the foreign policies of the India as a external affairs, and the minister apart from being the Prime Minister as the as well. So when after 1947 when become the Prime Minister for India, he was not working only as a Prime Minister, who Jawaharlal Nehru, but he was maintaining the foreign relations. He was become the one of the foreign minister to develop the relations with the other countries. So he was doing the internal work and also with the external work to follow the good relation. That job was completed by the Jawaharlal Nehru. That also declared in the radio program. Hence, many of times the foreign policies of the India is also called as the foreign policies of Nehru. So due to the hard work made by the Nehru, it is going to called as the what was the Indian foreign policy was developed by Indian government, that foreign policy is going to be called as the Indian Nehru policy developed with the foreign countries. Then the various international and the national issues have influenced the foreign policy of India. Due to the development of this Indian foreign policy, many of the few other countries also motivated toward the Indian foreign policy. They have started to use the Indian foreign policy because they are finding this policy is very good for their countries also, and it was benefited to them. So they have started to utilize the Indian foreign policy which was developed by Indian government. So the point related to the this interest was, this is like national interest, geographical interest, political situations, economic interest, military issues, public opinions, international situations, and many other issues have influenced the shape of Indian foreign policy. Why the other countries have started to motivate toward the Indian foreign policy? Because this foreign policy connected with the many points, many activities. The activities like economic development, political development, military development, natural development, national development, and also international good relations development. And there was also a point we are finding they want to develop the peace in the world. So that's why it became a very important part for the foreign policy related to the India, which developed in the period of before independence and the after independence by our national leaders. So the next point is we are going to see after this we are finding India also developed some new points. So these are the last few points just related to the only what purpose, only the purpose of that is the point related to the India itself. It is going to be called as the Indian foreign policy. It was not with the other countries. And the next policy was developed by the Indian government after independence, that at the time of need, that in the 1954 with the China, that is called as the foreign policy started by the Indian government. So the next point, India has started the development of foreign policy because it was thought that it was a need for the India. So the first Indian foreign policy was started in the 1954, because always India want to develop the foreign policy according to the needs and for the development of few activities in the country. Because at the time of when reached to the independence, the India was totally a poor country in the world. It was going to be called as a poor country. So that time, one of the principle followed, that is going to be called as the basic aspects of the Indian foreign policy, it was started in the 1947 with the some different principles. So India started the first principles and the first foreign policy was developed in 1954 with the China. So that policy itself is going to be called as the Panchsila foreign policy. It means the policy started with the name of Panchsila principles. Panchsila principles means there are five principles followed by the two countries to maintain the relation. So why these two countries needed the development or the needed the maintenance of the foreign policy with each other? Because the aim of these Panchsila principles was, though the countries are having their own all development, again they needed the development of their social development, economical development, political development, cultural development, and they want to develop the relations, good relations with the other countries, even though already they are having all these points with their countries. They are having the cultural system, they are having the economic system, they are having the political system, they are having their own social system, but still again these countries want to share their these all activities to each other to maintain the peace among the two countries. So first time the India was developed the foreign policy based on the similar lines. in 1954. So both the India and China has accepted the Panchashila principle. They have agreed to sign the which principle? Panchashila principle. There are the five principles were written in the document. According to this document, both the countries' prime ministers have signed to this agreement. So what were the points related to this agreement made between the China and India in 1954? So according to this Panchashila principles, they want to foster the international relations. They want to develop the international relationship. So that time Jawaharlal Nehru, the Prime Minister of India, and the ally was the Prime Minister for China, both have agreed to sign the Panchashila principles and they are ready to agree the following points. So what are the following points related to this agreement made by the both countries? So there are the few points we are going to see related to the Panchashila agreement or the Panchashila principles followed by the government of India and the government of China. So the first point is respecting the each other sovereignty and the regional interest. So India is also going to be called as a sovereign country. China is also going to be called as a sovereign country, but there is no any inter-state or the inter-country relations or internal issues should not be disturbed by the any country. So they can make their own choice. They can follow their own steps to develop their countries. But regarding the discussion with the two countries, they can discuss any point. Here means we must respect to the each sovereignty. For their independence, we have to be give respect and we have to be maintain the regional interest. We have to follow our own country development, not to the other country's point. It should not discuss with the each other. So they have to be show interest their regional power. Next point is non-invention of each other. So why they have agreed to sign this agreement? There is no invention on each other countries. India should not make attack towards the China and China should not make attack towards the India at any condition. That was the second point written in this document. And third one, that is non-interference in each other international issues. If they are following any relations with the other countries, China may be going to get the relations with the Russia, India may be going to get the relations with the America, that time China should not make any issues toward the international or the internal issues related to the India, or the India should not make any issue toward the China at the time of internal issue related to that country. That was the third